Thank you, Chair. The growth of the Euro-Atlantic community has turned out to be one of the greatest forces in human history for advancing peace, prosperity, security, and democracy. This is a direct quote of Vice President Biden back in 2014, and I couldn't agree with him more. So let's put these great words into action and let's rebuild our transatlantic relationship, a relationship based on our common values and objectives, with a United States that believes in multilateralism and wants to tackle global challenges together. A United States that wishes to preserve rules-based trade and fight climate change. The tariff reduction deal, or the so-called lobster deal that we are discussing today, is a positive step towards these better transatlantic trade relations. It is the first deal of its kind between the European Union and the United States within 20 years. And even though the scope is limited, I believe it is a strong political signal from our side that we want to do business with our American friends. But like any friendship, we should also be frank with each other. So let us be very clear that the times of punitive tariffs are over. We have been turning the other cheek for too long. I hope we can stop the additional tariffs on each other's products and that the new administration also understands that there is no sense in punishing our Gouda cheese, meat or wine producers, which in turn forces us to hit American cheddar, ketchup and chocolate producers with the same tariffs. In conclusion, this tariff reduction deal that we are voting on here today is important. Instead of introducing new tariffs, we are removing them. It is high time for a constructive approach. We now have the possibility to strengthen our transatlantic trade relationship for the benefits of our citizens and our businesses. I invite the new Biden administration to join us in these ambitions. Thank you.